Was Napoleon a sorcerer who was proficient in black magic and the occult? According to several sources, Napoleon was a master of the dark arts and ruled France through his knowledge of the occult. One of these sources originates from a Jewish ultra-Orthodox movement from Russia called Chabad Lubavitch. The founder of this movement, Rabbi Shneur Zalman of Liadi, otherwise known as the Alter Rebbe, was the only rabbi of his time who opposed Napoleon's advance into Russia. The Alter Rebbe equated Napoleon to Satan himself. When Napoleon's advancing armies approached Rabbi Shneur Zalman's hometown of Liadi, the Rebbe was forced to flee. The Rebbe left Liadi with 60 wagons carrying his extended family and many of his chassidim, escorted by a troop of soldiers attached to the convoy by express order of the Tsar. After traveling approximately 2 miles, the Alter Rebbe asked the commander for a fast carriage and horses. Together with 2 attendants, he returned to Liadi and instructed them to search the house for anything that might have been left behind. After a thorough search, they found a pair of worn-out slippers, a sieve, and a rolling pin in the attic. Not wanting Napoleon to obtain any memorabilia from him, the Alter Rebbe took these objects with him. The Alter Rebbe thought that Napoleon was a sorcerer, and if he would have gotten hold of anything that belonged to the Alter Rebbe, he would have used it to guarantee his victory, or in the least, to mitigate against the Alter Rebbe's ability to oppose him. Then he told his attendants to set fire to the house, and they left. Another source that speaks about Napoleon's connect to the occult is a book called Napoleon's Book of Fate and Oraculum. In 1813, he was defeated at Leipzig, and behind him was a cabinet of curiosities in which a Prussian officer discovered his Book of Fate and Oraculum. Originally, this oraculum was discovered in one of the royal tombs of Egypt during a French military expedition of 1801. The emperor ordered the manuscript to be translated by a famous German scholar and antiquarian. From that time onward, the oraculum was one of Napoleon's most treasured possessions. He consulted it on many occasions, and it is said to have formed a stimulus to his most speculative and most successful enterprises. Several historians have also claimed that Napoleon had links to Freemasonry and the Jesuit order. Masonic researcher G.S. Tuckett addresses the situation. It is strange that evidence in favor of the great Napoleon's membership of the Masonic Brotherhood has never been examined in detail, for the matter is surely one of interest, and seeing the remarkable part that remarkable men played in the affairs of Europe at a time when continental Freemasonry was struggling out of chaos into regular order, it cannot be without an important bearing upon Masonic history. In his essay on Napoleon and Masonry, Tuckett claims, "There is incontestable evidence that Napoleon was acquainted with the nature, aims, and organization of Freemasonry, that he approved of and made use of it to further his own ends." Jess Tuckett, Napoleon I and Freemasonry.